Hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Min Woo Shin, a second year MDiv student of the Claremont School of Theology and also youth pastor at Lost Village Korean United Methodist Church. There are people out there who worry about the future of Methodism, specifically Methodism in the United States. You know, they are worried about the shrinking number and declining faith, stuff like that. However, while I'm taking this United Methodist Doctrine class, which is an online class of Claremont School of Theology, I found out that there is still a lot in the Methodist tradition that we can offer to the entire church and thereby to the world as well, hopefully. So I made this little clip, which is a final project for the class, and I wanted to share with you guys about what I found from the class, you know, some like the beautiful teaching that I found from the class about Methodism. Okay, before we do that, let's have some pop quiz time real quick. Okay, first, a relatively easy one. Which of the three persons of Trinity do you think has most to do with the United Methodist logo, which looks like this? Do you get it? The answer is, of course, God the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Holy Trinity, and this actually has to do with the first part of my presentation, which is going to be about how we United Methodists as descendant of John Wesley understand the great teaching about the Holy Trinity. Alright, second one. Although this one is not specifically about Methodism, but it's still part of our Methodist beliefs, especially how we Methodists understand humanity, kind of big picture. So here's a question. Okay. So Felix Culpa, do you know what that means? Can you explain? I will get back to this point in my second part of the presentation, alright? So just like we thought about the Holy Trinity real quick in the first pop quiz, one of my most intriguing foundations from the class about Methodism is that the whole Methodist tradition is really solid based on the Christian teaching on Trinity. The great Methodist theologian Randy Maddox, in his book Responsible Grace, I'll show you an image of the book. Anyway, in his book in page number 140, he even says that John Wesley's implicit grammar for all Christian beliefs was actually this teaching about Trinity. Wesley even attributed each dimension of salvation to each person of the Trinity. Wesley read Trinitarian traces from various scripture verses and analyzed Trinitarian structure even from his thinking on prevenient grace. You know, early Methodists drew an insight from Holy Spirit and applied it to their distinctive practice of itinerancy of the Christian minister of the day. You know, they believed that just as the Holy Spirit is eternally being sent both from God the Father and the Son, we ministers should be sent to wherever we call to be sent. And Methodists also share a great conviction about the second person of the Holy Trinity, which is the God the Son. And just like one of our bishops said, in this incarnation of God the Son as Jesus Christ, we understand that, quote, God is now not vague, aloof, ineffable, and unknowable. God now has a face, a name, a certain way of talking and living and dying and rising. And we should also remember that Methodists also, you know, have always been in the same page with other Christian denominations. The Holy Spirit has distinctive personality rather than, as some say, quote unquote, impersonal energy. That is not how the Methodists understand the Holy Spirit at all. So wrapping up, for Methodists, the grammar of whole Christian faith was again this teaching about Holy Trinity. Mm-hmm. Okay, so next part of my presentation on Methodism. Just as I promised in the pop quiz, we will now get to think about how we Methodists understand humanity with that exotic phrase, Felix Kolpa, remember? I mean, in general, United Methodist doctrine hold similar belief about the original sin, the depravity of humanity, and all that, just like many other Christian denominations do, you know. Wesley was quite definitive, especially about the corrupted nature of humanity. I mean, he did not allow any room for Pelagian view that people destroy one's good nature by making bad choices. Wesley, in that sermon, you know, in one of his sermons, points that pride is a mentalized form of idolatry. So he used this strong language to describe this depravity of humanity, okay? And he pinpoint self-will as Satan's own image on our hearts that Satan stamped. So, again, another strong language about the nature, the depraved nature of humanity, okay? And I think this is really remarkable that he used in his sermon, in the same sermon, this quite modern phrase, you know, talking about pride, we worship ourselves. I mean, isn't this amazing? So Wesley was very definitive about the depravity of humanity, just like I said, you know, and building on this firm belief about depravity, the Methodists subsequently developed that theological perspective of Felix Kolpa, which means praise God for the fall. Praise God for the fall. I mean, you might think, wait, you crazy? Praise God for the fall? That's a nonsense. What a nonsense. You know, you might think that way, but as Kenneth Collins said, again, here you go. I'm showing you every image of the book that I'm quoting. So in his book, page 109 to 110, Kenneth Collins says that this happy fault of Adam and Eve, referring of course to the original sin, was some refers to by the Latin phrase Felix Kolpa, necessitates the coming of Christ and his atoning death such that a far greater good comes out of this original evil than is otherwise possible. So here's this very, very deep, ironical, theological perspective that we Methodists view. It's all this mess, you know, mass of humanity, like, you know, and just like I read, this conviction that God can make this absolute good even out of this depraved humanity is, I believe, is another very important thing that we United Methodists of today should hold. Well, in the interest of time, I haven't been able to share as much as I'd like to do, but well, my prayer is that, just like I said earlier, many people out there be able to, you know, find again the beauty of Methodism, start from John Wesley and to the present. And also, my prayer is that we all see the future that United Methodism be able to contribute to the future of Christianity the way it can do the best. That's my prayer. Amen.